In today's lesson, we're going to start to work with logarithms. Some equations that have an unknown in the exponent position are easy to solve because we can write both sides of the equation with the same base. For example, 3 raised to the x equals 27. I'm going to ask you to solve for x. So what I would suggest would be to rewrite the 27 with a base of 3. So 27 rewritten with a base of 3 becomes 3 raised to the third, because 3 times 3 times 3 is 27. And our original equation goes from 3 raised to the x equals 27 to 3 raised to the x equals 3 raised to the third. And you can see that x equals 3 is our only solution. So back to the original question, solve for x when I have 3 to the x equals 27. Well, our answer is x equals 3. Let's try another problem. We have 2 raised to the x equals 16, and I want you to solve for x. Well, we can write the 16 with a base of 2. So 2 raised to the 4 is equivalent to 16, because 2 times 2 times 2 times 2 is 16. So we now have 2 to the x equals 2 to the 4. The only value of x that will make this true is 4. Let's try one more. 2 to the x equals 1 over 16. Well, we can rewrite 1 over 16 with a base of 2. 1 over 16 with a base of 2 becomes 2 to the negative 4. If you remember from the lessons with negative exponents, when you have a negative exponent, you take the reciprocal of your base and make the exponent positive. So 2 to the x equals 1 over 16 is the same as 2 to the x equals 2 to the negative 4. And the only value for x that will make this true is negative 4. So x equals negative 4. So back to the original question, 2 to the x equals 1 over 16, solve for x. Your answer is going to be x equals negative 4. Unfortunately, most exponential equations can't be solved so easily. For example, if I have 2 to the x equals 13, I cannot write 13 with a base of 2. We can estimate a value for x, because I know that 2 raised to the third is 8, so if I put a 3 into the x, I'd have 8, and if I put a 4 in for x, I'd have 16. So I know 13 is in between 8 and 16, so my answer would have to be somewhere between 3 and 4. Right? The value of x that's going to make this true was somewhere in between 3 and 4. That's my estimate. However, sometimes an estimate's not good enough. If I wanted an exact answer, we're going to have to use the logarithm. Right, to solve this equation for x, we will need to undo the exponent base 2 by using the inverse operation on the other side of the equation. That inverse operation is called the logarithm. So we're going to introduce that in part 2. So look for the video that says logs part 2, and we will actually start to deal with logs.